Hello everyone, in this tutorial we are going to explore the basics of Move Physics, the new hair physics simulation operator introduced in Ornatrix version 2 for Maya. This new operator is designed to be more precise and accurate compared to our old Dynamics operator. It is CPU based, so it does not depend on Nvidia Flex anymore. This operator is expandable via Python script, which is perfect for TDs who want to use their own physics algorithms or add extra controllers. As I said before, this operator will allow you to get physically accurate simulations with a bit of work, so we have to understand what the controllers do. That's why we are here now. Let's get started. As you can see, Move Physics is deactivated. It's not doing anything at the moment, and the animation is being played by the animation catch operator, which is used to bake the simulation. That's what we are going to do in the end. But now, if I deactivate the animation catch operator and activate move, you can see the simulation running instead of the catch animation. Let's delete this one and start from scratch. Find the new operator on the Ornatrix shelf and add it to the stack on top of your guides. We have a few tabs here. Starting from the top, we have simulation controls, force fields, collision meshes, simulation parameters, and visualization controls. In simulation controls is where you can load your custom simulation scripts. Have in mind that you don't have to write your own simulation script. This is just an option to those who want to expand Move Physics. You can also capture an initial state for the simulation, remove it, or simulate a rest state. We are going back to those controls later on this video. Next, we have force fields where you can add Maya's default fields or solvers like air, drag, gravity or vortex, etc. We will see this more in depth in the next tutorial. Next, we have collision meshes. This is self-explanatory. This is where you can add any external collision meshes to interact with the hair simulation. We will see this later in this video. Simulation parameters is where you have all the fun. Here we have all the sliders to tweak the behavior of the simulation. And visualization controls help you to debug your simulation. Here you can display the constraints, particles, velocities, and more. Going back to the simulation parameters, let's run the simulation to see how it looks. As you can see, this doesn't look how we want. First of all, the shape of the groom is not preserved and there is a bit of stretching on the guides. Let's fix the stretching first. We have several options to solve this. One is increasing the simulator steps to get a more accurate simulation and collisions and stiffer constraints so the hair particles have less stretching but at the cost of performance. The simulation looks much better now. Just for the sake of completion, let's set this back to default values and try something else. Another option is changing the model type, which determines the constraints applied to the hair particles, but some are faster or accurate than others, or in some cases, a combination of two model types. For example, distance only, that uses spring constraint, or Coserat distance, which have the properties of distance only, plus Coserat, which uses additional distance constraints to remove this stretching that we don't want in our simulation. In this case, Coserat distance works better. We will see the rest of the model types in another video. Now that the stretching is gone, we can focus on improving the simulation. First, we want to preserve the shape of the groom, including the hair parting. For that, we need the Attract to Initial Shape option. This option creates springs that attract each hair strand to its initial shape. We also need the Group Holder options to help keep the hair parting intact. This option will make sure the green and pink strand group stay away from each other. If we run the simulation now, you can see how Move is trying to preserve the party. Let's increase the attract to initial shape value and see how it looks. That's much better. You can see how the simulation is trying to preserve the shape of the hair. You can also use the ramp curve to determine how stiff is the hair from the root to the tips. Maybe something like this. We want a stiffer roots. Okay, maybe a little bit more stiffness at the tips. Okay, that's much better, but the hair is too stiff now. We have to find a way to compensate this. In this case, we can use the gravity scale parameter to increase the scale of the gravitational field. This will help to preserve the shape of the hair without having to make the hair even more stiff using the attract to initial shape parameter. Looks better, but the hair is still too stiff and the tips are jumping too much. Let's try changing the mass per vertex parameter to increase the particle mass of the hair. The particle mass determines the response to the springs created by attract to initial shape. This will help us to compensate the excessive stiffness created by attract to initial shape in this case. As you can see, the hair have a much better response to the running animation and the movement looks more natural. We may even increase this value and play with attract to initial shape a bit more. This is a good improvement. We are getting closer and closer. It's always a good idea to watch your simulation at the distance to have a better perspective. Use the drag parameter to introduce damping in the simulation. This will help us to smooth out the movement. Smaller values will add more damping. Play with lower values if you are trying to simulate hair underwater, for example. We have a nice flow here. I think this is good for now. But I can notice that the points closer to the roots are not moving too much. We can fix this using the root holder option. This option will allow us to modify the position of the initial particle where the simulation starts. Lower values will move the particle closer to the roots. Let's give it a try. In this case, I will lower the root stiffness to 25 and run the simulation to see how it looks. This is looking good. Now we are ready to experiment with hair collisions in the next video. If you have any questions, please write me to the email found in the description or join our Facebook groups. See you guys in the next video.